we are having the keyword called global. What exactly the global keyword is? First of all, we need to understand the scope of the variables within a function and outside the function. Suppose if I'm going to create a variable, suppose this is the method we are having, def. Suppose I'm going to create a method like def display. In the display, we are having the nm is equal to, suppose I'm going to give Santosh. And I'm going to print nm. Nothing wrong with this. And I'm going to call the method, it's perfectly fine. But if again I'm going to print nm, what we will get over here? What will be the output of this?
I think you're mute, I can't hear you.
Pardon? Okay, I'm just going to discuss the few things. Like the first one is the global and globals. Suppose we need to discuss the scope of the variables. Suppose what I'm going to do, and this is the method we are having. In this particular method, we are having the function like attribute is there, like nm, and I'm going to display the nm, perfectly fine, nothing wrong with this. And I'm going to call the method display. After calling this display, I'm going to declare the, again, I'm going to display the print nm over there. If I'm going to run this program, first of all, I need to save this. I'm going to save this program. And suppose this is the name we are having. And I'm going to run this. We are getting the Santosh, but now after this, I'm getting the error, like name error. Name nm is not defined. We are getting the name error. Name nm is not defined. Why? Because when we declare any functions, any variables within a function, by default it's a local scope. This nm is only accessible within this particular function. We cannot call the nm from the outside of the function because it's a local scope. Local scope means what? This function is only accessible within a function. We cannot call it from the outside of the function. This is the first thing. So this is what? It's a local variable. It's a local scope. Local scope means what? Only accessible within function. We cannot call this outside of the function. So it's a local scope. So this is the example of local scope, how we can create the function with local scope. Okay. Now, once again, I'm going to write the program. And suppose in this program I am going to declare the variable over here and I am going to write nm is equal to Santosh. And I am just going to put g over there because this is the global variable. Any functions, any variables that I am going to declare or initialize outside of the function, it's a global scope. So this is the global variable. And now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to print the nm, nothing wrong with this. Display, it will call the this one. And again, if I'm going to call this nm, again, we will get the g Santosh over there. Yeah, we are getting. The first time we are getting g Santosh for this, because we are calling this method. And the next time we are getting this. So this is what, this is the global scope. It's a global scope. Global scope means what? Global scope means what? We can call it within the function, or outside of the function. This is the global scope of the variable. I'm just going to declare nm is of type g Santosh, and within this function I'm calling this, perfectly fine, nothing wrong with that. And even after the function I'm going to call this, it's perfectly fine. Now my question is, I'm just going to make it comment. So this is the local and global scope, the first thing. The second thing is, now what I need to do, Again, I am going to talk about the global only. So this is the variable we are having, and I'm going to make the changes over there. Like nm is equal to, suppose I'm just going to give like USA Mr. Trump. I'm just going to give this value over there, and I'm going to display the print nm. And again, I'm going to display, going to call this display, and again, I'm going to call the print nm. Let's run it. Here we are going to get the USA Mr. Trump, and here we are going to get G Santos. The thing is that basically when we are going to declare, I'm going to assign the value for this, it's get changed over here. It's in the local scope, it's a local. So having the highest priorities on this. So because we define that, we change the values over there, that's why we are getting this value. But outside of the function, even after calling the function, we are getting the previous value only. We are getting the previous value only. So, okay, do one thing. I'm just going to print ID of NM. And again, I'm going to print the ID of NM. Run this. See, what is this? It's a different memory address, and it's a different memory address. So what I'm trying to say, like when you are going to make the changes with the global variable in the local function, it will create a separate copy. It's a different copy. It's a local variable now, having the different memory allocation, and this variable having the different memory allocation. See, this is the memory address of this USA Mr. Trump, and this is the memory address of your global variable. So remember, even it's a local variable and the global variable having the same name, but it's a different copy. That particular NM is different and this particular NM is different. This is what exactly the concepts with the global and local. Local having the highest priority on the global. That's why when we are writing print NM, it's going to display this NM. When I'm going to print ID of NM, it's going to display the ID of this print, this NM. Now, what I want to do, so remember, when we make the copy of global variable, it's a separate copy, nothing with the, to do with the global. Okay, now what I want to do, I'm looking for, like, if I'm going to make the changes like NM is equal to USA Mr. Trump, I want to make the change with the global variable. I don't want to create the separate copy. I want to make the changes with the global variable. So how we can do that? For that purpose, we are having the keyword called global. By the use of global keyword, we are having the permission to make the changes with the global variable. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use the global keyword over there. And this global keyword give me the permission to make the changes with that global variables. Global NM, now the print NM, I'm going to print this, and again I'm going to run this. See, USA Mr. Trump, we are getting this, and this is the ID of this NM, yeah, 832, and this is again I'm going to display and going to print NM. It's get change, and it's again on the same ID. See, it's again on the same ID. So this is what exactly the keyword global is. So global keyword allow us to make the changes with the global variable. This global keyword allow us to make changes with global variables. This is what exactly the global keyword is. Global keyword allows us to make the changes with the global variable. It's a global variable. I want to make the changes over there. I'm just going to write global NM. Now, whatever the changes I'm going to perform with the NM, that will get reflected with this. And that's why when I'm going to display the NM, when I'm going to display the NM again, it's going to make the impact on this N. So this is what exactly the global keyword is. So by the use of global keyword, you can access the global variable and you can make the changes over there. And you can make the changes over there, and whatever the changes you are going to do, it's become the permanent for that global particular variables. So this is what exactly the global keyword is. Now, tis the next one is globals. What exactly the globals is?
Yeah, that's the one I
don't know. Yeah, that's why. That's why this topic is there with you. Yeah, now we are having the keyword called globals. Basically, globals is not the keyword; it's a function. It's a function. And what exactly the concept of this global function is? See, it's basically, suppose my question is, and that question will be the answer of your problem. Suppose my question is, can we make the global and local variable name same? My question is, can we make global and local variable names name? This is my question.
Yes.
Yes, I think.
No, that's yes is fine. Okay, here I'm going to make, but it's a separate copy. It's a separate copy. So my question is like, can we make the global and local variable with the same name? Yes, we can do that. And for that purpose, what we are having the function, and that function is known as the global function. That function is known as global function. Global function or return a dictionary object of all global variables, of all global variables, all global variables and their respective values and their values. So basically, global function, it's a function, and this function return a dictionary object of all the global variables and their values. I'm just going to give the example. Suppose I'm going to use the keyword, this is the another example. I'm just going to use the keyword like, I'm going to declare the variable. Suppose my variable is, I'm going to use like nm is equal to, I'm just going to use like nm is equal to symbols. It's a global variable for me. I'm going to define diff display. And because it's a global variable, so what we can do, we can also access like this, globals function. And because it will return me the dictionary object, so what I'm going to do, I'm just going to put like nm is equal to, and I'm going to put the values for this, like the value is Smith from USA. So this global is basically what? It's a function, and this function return a dictionary object of all the global variable. This one is my global variable. I'm going to make the changes with this. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write nm is equal to, suppose I'm going to give like Santosh from India. Remember, here I'm also assigning the nm and the values for nm. Here we are also assigning the value for nm. This nm is different and this nm is different. This nm is a global variable and this nm is the local variable. What I'm going to do, I'm just going to display this print. I'm just going to print like nm. And I'm going to print this also. Yeah. and I'm going to call this method display. Display, run this. So we are getting the value Santosh from India, and we are getting this value like global NM. I just need to apply the print over there, print of global of NM. Run this. So we are getting Santosh from India because it's a local variable. This we are getting, and we are also getting the values like print global of NM. So we are getting this like Smith from USA. This is the value that we are getting. Why we are getting this is the reference number that we are getting because it's a global variable. So this is what exactly the global keyword is, the global function is. Global function is basically having this. This is the purpose of the global function. Basically, by the use of global function, we can access the global variables over there. By the use of this global function, we can access the global variable level over there. And what are the scenarios to use the global function? If I want to declare the variables, like if I want to make the local variable and the global variable be the same name, for that purpose, what we can use the global keyword over there. And this is the global keyword that we are using. Got it?
Yeah, I got it now.
So this is the use of global function. So global function is what? It's a function. It's return a dictionary object of all global variables and their values. So this is the global keyword, global function. This is the global keyword. And this is the global variables. And this is the local variable. It's a local scope. It's a global scope. And this is how we can make the changes. And this is how we can make the copy and all. So this is all regarding the local and global and the scope of the variables within the function, outside of the function. Okay, this is about the global and global function. Okay, one important thing is there, like we are having the called assert statement. What exactly the assert statement is? For the assert statement in Python, what exactly is that? I'm just going to show you what exactly the assert statement is. What exactly the assert statement is? This statement is basically for just to check whether the given logical expression is true or false. Just to check like the given logical expression is true and false. This is what exactly the assert statement is. Suppose I'm just going to write, like I'm going to create a function over there. Suppose I'm just going to write n is equal to, I'm just going to create a simple program, n is equal to input, and I'm just going to give like enter num. And I'm just going to use int enter number. I'm just going to make the change. Now, I'm just going to put assert and greater than equal to 0. Print the number is comma. And I'm going to display that. Run this. Enter the number. I'm going to give 123. And we are getting. Oh. Run this. Enter the number. And we are getting the number is 332. Do one thing. Enter the number and I'm going to give minus 90. See what we are getting. We are getting the assertion error. We are just getting the assertion error. We are not writing anything. We are not doing anything. But we are still getting the error. And this is just to check the expression. like this particular expression is true or false. That's it. So assert a statement is just to check the given logical expression is true or false. So if it's true, everything is perfectly fine, nothing wrong with that. If it's going to be false, it will raise the error. So this is what exactly the assert a statement is. It's a small thing, but it's again important. Like this is what exactly we can use the assert a statement. Even in the assert statement, we can also put some message. Even in the assert statement, we can also put some messages over there. Like I'm just going to use assert n greater than 0, perfectly fine. Otherwise, I'm just writing only positive number is allowed. So we can also put some message over there. So now if I'm going to run this, enter number, perfectly fine. Again run this, and I'm just going to minus 90. We are getting the assert error. Other than the error, we are also going to get the message only positive number is allowed. So this is what exactly the assert is. This is the assert statement. We can also what the exceptions we are getting over here. We are getting the assertion error. So even we can also handle the exceptions over there. We can also handle the exceptions and all. So this is basically the assert statement is. Assert statement is nothing. It is just going to check whether whatever the statement you are going to pass, logically it's a true or false. So this is what exactly the assert statement is. Got it? Small thing, but it's again important for the interview point of view. I'm just going to make it copy again. Okay. One important thing is there, in Python we are having the concept of magic method. What exactly is that? We are having the concept of magic method. Oh, magic methods. What exactly the concept of this magic method is? Yeah, basically magic method are basically it's a special kind of method that really add the magic with your programs and all in your class. Remember, magic method, we cannot this function get called automatically when you perform the certain operation. I am going to show you the list of the magic method. I'm just going to write dir int. These are the magic method related with the dir integer. These are the different types of whatever the method we are writing underscore, that's exactly what it's a magic method. Suppose I am going to write a is equal to 10, 20, and I'm just going to write a plus 5. What we are getting? We are getting 25. This is equal to a dot underscore underscore add 5 underscore underscore 5. So this is what, this is the same. You are already familiar with. You just need to revise your topic, the list and all. And that particular topic again I cover this. So this is what, this is the magic method. So magic method is basically it's a special kind of method, and that method will get called when we perform the certain operation. Like here we are performing the certain operation. I'm going to put the add. Internally this particular method is going to call over there. So these methods are what? These are the magic method. The underscore underscore. See?